Hey, good morning. This is Frank over at the cave. It's nice and early today. Sun just coming up. Just finished our first workout. It was great. CrossFit WOD at 6:30 a.m. Now taking a short study break and kind of get organized for the day a little further. Having some water. I know you probably thought it was going to be coffee in this video, but it's water. Anyway, I want to talk to you a little bit about today about coaching and being a good athlete, all right? Now, if you're going to be a coach, you should also be a good athlete. Not just telling people what to do, but living it out. My mentor, Zach Evanes, calls it living the code, and that's good. And in other words, don't be a hypocrite. You know, hypocrisy doesn't just happen in religion. It happens in this fitness world a lot. So you want people to be getting stronger and more fit, you need to be getting stronger and more fit. That's another video, though. Right now, we're talking about learning. Now, behind me on the wall, you see numerous certificates from different training courses, certifications, and so on, martial arts, CrossFit, underground strength, NSCA, USAW, and that's all great stuff, and I'm thankful for the learning opportunities I've had with all of that. But once the certificate goes on the wall, that's the beginning of learning. That's not the end. Okay, anybody can go to a shake and bake certification, get some cheapo certificate to hang on their wall and get a t-shirt, call themselves a trainer, and that's rampant throughout the fitness world. We're talking about people that want to be good, solid athletes and coaches. It's going to take way more than that. Way more than that. Now, excuse me. Over here, which you can't see, I'll kind of flip the camera for a minute. You got a whole stack of books and manuals. Some of my reading material there. You got to stay after this thing knowledge-wise all the time, all the time. If you're not moving forward, you're going backwards. This is a fast-paced world that's moving very quickly in the advancement of knowledge, and I should say in the application of knowledge is what we're really looking at. Okay, knowledge is there's volumes and volumes of knowledge available to people. There's so much available that many people just shut down. They don't want to learn anything. Too much information, as the saying goes. So rather than waste your time with just doing scatterbrain stuff online, just picking and just kind of poking around on the internet, let's look at a few things that I've been using that I think you might find very helpful, okay? I'm going to start off with a couple of the very foundational things that helped me get a really good start in coaching and as an athlete. Excuse me. There's a lot of allergens in the air this week, so hang in there with me. Okay, one of my all-time favorites, Zach Evanes' Underground Strength Manual. This is a classic. If you haven't read this and studied this, you're really missing out. Okay, another one. Louis Simmons, West Side Barbell, Book of Methods. Awesome. Louis Simmons has influenced some of the best coaches on earth. And his performance of his athletes, in my opinion, is second to none. Now, there's the NSCA. Okay? Now, a lot of people, they missed this one. This is a good one, okay? Strength and Conditioning Journal from the National Strength and Conditioning Association. One I recently got a hold of from Dave Tate, the lead FTS, The Vault. Excellent. Okay, we're going to move on a little bit. One of my most favorite resources, the CrossFit Journal. Now, you don't have to be in CrossFit to read the CrossFit Journal, though I recommend you are. This is an awesome resource. and it's interactive back through for the last 10 years. So whatever their database is, you can go in there and you can learn all kinds of good stuff there. Now, if you're a CrossFit hater, don't bother. Okay, here's a couple more for you, more recent, okay? Coach Meglio, deadlifting like a beast. Good one. Becoming a Machine, Mike Bruce. Homemade cover because it's an ebook. Elliot Hulse, the Incredible Hulse, as they call him. A hybrid, hardcore hybrid strongman training. That's a little difficult to say. And here's one from one of my old instructors in Russian Sistema. That's a Russian martial art. It's called The Forge by Sonny Pazikas, which is some of the most radical body weight and kettlebell training I've seen from anybody. And I did have the good fortune to train with him for several months when he lived in our area before he moved on and became rich and famous. Anyway, that's some of the stuff that I really recommend. It's very good. Dig into it, and you find a lot of benefit there for yourself. Never stop learning. Never think you've arrived. Never think you know it all. And as the old cowboy philosopher once said, it's what you learn after you know it all that counts. All right. At the cave, later on.